Hello class 10th, hope you all are good. Students, today in this video I am going to continue the same chapter in chemistry, that is your what acid, bases and salt. In previous video we had discussed about the definitions of acid, bases and alkalis, right? And different types of acids. Today, in this video, I'm going to discuss about the first basicity of an acid and how the acids are formed and their physical and chemical properties. Let's start the chapter. Now, first is your basicity of acids. Now, what do you mean by basicity of acids? Actually, it is a number of hydrogen ions which can be produced per molecule of the acid in aqueous solution is called what basicity of acids. For example, one molecule of hydrochloric acid produces one hydrogen ion, and sulfuric acid of produce two hydrogen ions, while phosphoric acid produces 3 hydrogen ions in per molecule of the acid in aqueous solution. So, number of hydrogen ions which can be produced per molecule of the acid is called what basicity of acids in its aqueous solution. And on the basis of it, there are 3 type of acids are there. First is your monobasic acid, right? For example, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, acetic acid, and diabasic acids examples are your sulfuric acid, sulfurous acid and carbonic acid. And third is your what tribasic acid, an example is your phosphoric acid. So what are monobasic acids? Monobasic acids are the acids which contains one replaceable hydrogen ion per molecule of the acid, or which produce one hydrogen ion per molecule of the acid in its aqueous solution, right? For example, hydrochloric acid dissolved in water, it gives you one hydronium ion or one hydrogen ion, right? And monobasic acid always form one type of salt only, means they form only normal salts. For example, when hydrochloric acid react with sodium hydroxide, it gives you sodium chloride and water. Same way, NaOH plus HNO3 gives you what? NaNO3 and water. Means give only normal salts. Right? Now, next is your diabasic acids. Now, what are diabasic acids? Which contains 2 replaceable hydrogen ions per molecule of the acid. Acid or diabasic acids, they always dissociate in 2 steps in aqueous solution, and that is why they form 2 types of salts. Just remember, diabasic acid always give 2 types of salt. For example, when sodium hydroxide react with sulfuric acid, it first give you sodium bisulfate, that is your acid salt, and water. And when sodium hydroxide replace both hydrogen ions, then it forms a normal salt, that is your sodium sulfate and water. So diabasic acids always give 2 types of salts, acid salt and normal salt. Understood? Third is your tribasic acid. So what are tribasic acids? Basic acids are the acids which contain 3 replaceable hydrogen ions per molecule of the acid. What they contain? 3 replaceable hydrogen ions per molecule of the acid, and they dissociate in 3 steps in aqueous solution. They always form 3 types of salts. What they form? 3 types of salts. First is your 2 acid salts and 1 normal salt. First it gives monosodium dihydrogen phosphate, then it gives disodium hydrogen phosphate, and then it gives a normal salt, that is your trisodium phosphate. What is the basicity of phosphoric acid? That is your 3. And basicity of sulfuric acid is 2, while basicity of hydrochloric acid is 1,
right?
Now next is your, what do you mean by concentrated acid and dilute acid? Actually, concentrated acid is acid in which contain high percentage of acid, and dilute acid is acid which contain low percentage of acid. It means a strong acid may be concentrated or may be dilute depending upon the percentage of acid, or in other side you can say that the percentage of water. If an acid contain more water, then it is dilute. If it contain less water, then what it is called, concentrated acid. Understood? These strong acids may be concentrated or may be dilute depending upon the percentage of acid.
Same way, acetic acid and carbonic acid are weak acid, and they may be concentrated or dilute acid depending upon the percentage of acid in them. Right.
Now next is your preparation of acids. How you will prepare acids? Acids. First is your from non-metals. Actually, when non-metals like chlorine, iodine, or bromine, when they react with hydrogen, they form acids. For example, when hydrogen react with chlorine, it give
hydrochloric acid.
Preparation is your from acidic oxides. You have learned in previous classes, whenever the non-metals like carbon, sulfur, or nitrogen, when they react with oxygen, they form acidic oxides. So the what they are called acidic oxides, when these acidic oxides
reacts with water, they form acids. For example,
when carbon dioxide react with water,
give carbonic acid, and same way sulfur dioxide gives sulfurous acid.
Right? And how the sulfuric acid is formed? When sulfur trioxide react with water, then it forms sulfuric acid. Right? Same way when phosphorus pentoxide P2O5 react with water, it gives you phosphoric acid. So the acids are prepared from acidic oxides when they dissolve in water.
Now third type of preparation is your formation of volatile acid from non-volatile acids when they are heated with salts of more volatile acid.
Same way when sulfuric acid react, concentrated sulfuric acid react with sodium chloride, it gives you sodium bisulfate and hydrochloric acid. Next is your physical properties of acids. Acids are always sour in taste in its aqueous solution, but never try to taste any acid, right? Especially which one? Strong acids or mineral acids. Mineral acids, they are highly corrosive in nature, and indicator wise they always turn blue litmus paper to red. Now what are the chemical properties? Acids whenever react with bases, when acids react with bases, they always give what? Salt and water, and this reaction is called what? Neutralization reaction. Next is your, when metals react with acids, well, especially dilute acids, they always give salt and hydrogen gas. Means as acids divide into two groups, strong acid and weak acid, the same way alkalis also divide into two groups, strong alkali and weak alkali, depending upon the strength of an alkali. So what is the strength of an alkali? It depends on the concentration of the hydroxyl ion present in aqueous solution of the alkali. Strong alkali is an alkali which dissociate almost completely in its aqueous solution, and thereby producing high concentration of hydroxyl ions. And for example, sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide are your strong alkalis because they dissociate completely and give or produce high concentration of hydroxyl ions. Understood? And strong alkalis like strong acids, they always contain what? Only ions. Next is your weak alkali. Is an alkali which dissociate only partially in aqueous solution, thereby producing a low concentration of hydroxyl ions. And examples of weak alkalis are your what? Ammonium hydroxide and calcium hydroxide, because they dissociate partially and produce low concentration of hydroxyl ions. And they contain what? Molecules and ions both in its aqueous solution. Right? Same way, an alkali may be concentrated or may be dilute depending upon the percentage of alkali. If an alkali contain high percentage of alkali in its aqueous solution, then it is called concentrated alkali. And if it contain low percentage of alkali in its aqueous solution, then it is called dilute alkali. And strong alkali may be concentrated or dilute. And the same way, weak alkali may be concentrated or dilute, depending upon the percentage of alkali in its aqueous solution. Next is your acidity of bases. What do you mean by acidity of bases? It is a number of hydroxyl ions which can be produced per molecule of the base in aqueous solution. For example, the sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, they have what? How many number of hydroxyl ions are there which can be produced per molecule of this base? That is your what? 1. Right? Sorry. Here in case of calcium hydroxide and magnesium hydroxide, they will produce 2 hydroxyl ions, right? While your aluminium hydroxide and iron-3 hydroxide, they will produce 3 hydroxyl ions per molecule of the base. So on the basis of their acidity of the base, they are again divided into 3 categories. And first is your what? Monoacidic base. What do you mean by monoacidic base? Which produce 1 hydroxyl ion per molecule of the base. Or you can say they contain 1 replaceable hydroxyl ion per molecule of the base. Right? For example, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide are monoacidic base. Second is your diacidic base. And these are, they ionize in aqueous solution to produce 2 hydroxyl ions per molecule of the base, or they contain 2 replaceable hydroxyl ions per molecule of the base. For example, calcium hydroxide, copper hydroxide. And they dissociate in 1 step in aqueous solution.
And the acidity of diacidic base is 2, right?
Now next is your triacidic base are the base which contain 3 replaceable hydroxyl ions per molecule of the base. For example, aluminium hydroxide and iron-3 hydroxide, and their acidity is what? 3. This is your preparation of bases. Bases can be prepared from metals. When metals react with oxygen, naturally they form what? Base. For example, sodium when react with oxygen, sodium oxide, magnesium when react with oxygen, it gives you magnesium oxide or basic oxides. Right now, when basic oxides react with water, when basic oxides are soluble in water, they dissolve in water and they give a base or alkali. Right now, for example, when potassium hydroxide dissolve in water, it gives you potassium hydroxide, and sodium hydroxide dissolve in water, it gives sodium hydroxide. Next is your what? When active matters, when they react with water, then also they give what? Bases or alkalis. For example, when potassium react with water, it always gives you potassium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. And sodium when react with water, it gives you sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Now third is yours. Some bases are also formed from the salts. Aqueous solution of salts with strong base precipitates a base, that is your metallic hydroxide. When aluminium chloride, that is your salt solution, when react with this sodium hydroxide, it gives you normal salt, NaCl, and another base, that is your aluminium hydroxide, means it gives a precipitate of aluminium hydroxide. Right, same way when iron-2 sulfate react with sodium hydroxide, it gives you another base, that is your iron-2 hydroxide. The precipitate of iron-2 hydroxide is formed, and another salt, sodium sulfate, is formed. Next is your physical properties of bases. Bases are always bitter in taste in aqueous solution. While caustic alkalis like potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide, they are highly corrosive in nature, and bases always turns red litmus blue. Right? Okay, thank you, children.